Good evening, good morning, family. Okay, I'm in the bathroom. I found this, and it's a Grout Revival from Unibond, but it says it's not that I'm promoting any brand, you know what I mean? But I thought I'd just let you know, because if it works, then that'll save me sanding the gaps of where the grout is and re-grouting rather than retiling, and that's just a lot of mess. So I think it's like a paint or some dye or bleach, I don't know. Let me see, it says it contains some scientific breakdown, which okay, to be honest, I don't know what it contains. Isothiazolinone mixture. It says it may be cause allergies to your skin. So either way, it's definitely chemicals. It says avoid breathing in. Wear protective gloves. Let's go get some gloves. Hang on, I've got some here for, you know, when doing my hair, so I guess that'll do the job. So, on my mental, can you understand what I'm saying? So I'm gonna get on with this, and I think it's gonna be like colouring in, because look, it's got like a nib, like a felt tip or a Sharpie. So, thinking that should be fun. So, let me put it on so it don't dry out. It says make sure you shake. Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it. Shake it like a... So, gloves on, because I've got contact dermatitis and I have to be careful with chemicals when they touch my skin. You know me, cup of tea, gotta have a tea to function. Right, I'm gonna have to climb in the bath, but it is what it is. I'll just have to wash it afterwards, because I've already washed it, which if I knew I was gonna do this, I wouldn't bother. But hopefully this works, so thinking it should zen me out, because that's a lot of tiles. Yeah, I've got a whole of a lot of tiles. Can you see? That's a lot of tiles. I mean, it goes over the window, underneath the sink. That's a lot of tiles, and yeah, that's only not much walls that's actually got paint on, but you can see that's a lot of tiles. So to be honest, I don't think this pen's going to cover it. I should have got two or three. Excuse me while I adjust the camera back as to I had it. How did I have it? Oh, why did I move it? You know how it goes. All right. There we go. So, yeah. Wish me luck. At least I'm not wearing the same clothes today. I thought this should be a clean job. So, yeah. I don't need to be wearing no work clothes. So let's see. Little tester one. Look, that's a blatantly black I've washed everything down already because it says, oh gosh, it says to make sure that you give it all a clean and there's no mold or like make sure it's dry and stuff. So let's try it. Look, that's an obvious one, so you'll be able to see if it makes any difference. Here we go. And if it does work, whew, I'd rather buy one of these and just do all of that. So, oh, what do you think? Don't look too bad, does it? I mean, they say if it's, you can do another coat later on, but you have to give it an hour to dry. So, I just know I don't have it. There's no way this is going to stretch over everything. I've got too much to do. I should have bought more. So I'll go back and the price has changed. Does that look like it's making a difference? That don't look too bad, does it? Well, first coat. While I'm here, might as well do this one. Okay. What do you reckon? Thought you might want to join me. Keep me company. Just get in the bath. And I guess this is a grown up colouring. Let's go down because don't try it. I mean, put the pen downwards because if it's up all the time, then there's no ink or whatever that liquid is that's coming out. So let's start from. Aha, gotcha. You gotta put a little bit of pressure on it. There's no way that's gonna do all of this. I'd be lucky to get halfway through. If it works. Yes, I will be going back to the shop and get another one. Unless Unibond want to send me one, I won't say no. As a gift. You know, as soon as I put your name out there. You know, just to say thank you. Too bad. Look, let me show you. that's what it's looking like for now. Well, that's a fresh layer, and that's the darker layer. Let me show you. Freshens it up a little. I mean, I'll only know when it properly dries. Well, what do you reckon? What do you reckon? Reckon that's any different? That don't look too bad for a little sprucey fresh. Just a fresh up. I'll see. Okay, let's do a half half. Yeah? Okay, well. Don't look too bad. It takes away the like dirt kind of lines, which was created by the moisture too much. Okay, I don't think this is definitely not gonna last on the to do the whole of this. It's only little. And because it's on the wall, it's a little bit awkward. Because, you know, if you write with a biro even, and it's not facing, pointing downwards, eventually the ink will start cutting out. And that's where you see people like shaking a pen. The nib is getting a little messed up already, because it's turning into a bit of a mini brush actually, more than a felt tip. It's getting a little bit messed up. It's not as pinpoint as it started off as. Just trying to let you guys see what I'm doing. Oh, that bit came out nice. Okay, you got to keep pressing it so it keeps flowing. Otherwise, it won't look too bad. I mean, I think it'll be better than it was. Not that much. Right, let's not overlay too many of the not do too many layers because I'll run out of this so-called ink before. What do you reckon? Done over there earlier. Actually, nice trying. They don't look too bad. The heavier what bits I'm gonna have to go over again. But yeah, it's not too bad. You got to get it to come out properly, and then it's kind of like more better, like kind of have a little spring pressure. Okay, there is a bit of a technique to this, otherwise it's not flowing. You've got a, it's got like a little spring tip. So kind of activate the spring slightly, but you don't want to overdo it, otherwise all the ink will run out too quick. Just gonna go up to hours. Okay, it might not take hours. If you get the flow right, it's actually quick. You've got to get the flow, otherwise you're just messing up the nib going backwards and forwards because the grout's grippy. Mm-hmm. Not bad at all. Yeah, the tip's already messed up. It's like a brush now, it's no longer. It's still doing the job. So cleaner. Right. You can see, look, I'll show you. Don't look too bad. You can see what I've done, and all like I've done from there to this line. Yeah, this line is done. And all of this way, but going that way, you can see where the I haven't done it because it's kind of black. Yeah. Okay. It's going to take some time, so bear with me. Highly advise you put your tunes in and you just get on with it. This is not having it. tip is messed up. Look, look at this. It's like, what the heck? Ooh. God. I don't know if that's meant to happen, but it's gonna work for me. Hopefully. Oh, come on. I'm not impressed. It was all right to start off with, but I think it's run out. Okay, I've got a little piece. not really impressed with the tip. Won't last 2 minutes. It's already falling apart. Like the idea of it's cool, but okay, when it wants to work, it does it good. Okay, people, it works, but that, look at the tip. Like, it's all sharp. It's all, like, it's not ideal when rubbing across the grout, and it says you need to press it to make the paint come out. And then when you do, it's like wearing your jeans and coming off a motorcycle, regular jeans, like, get shredded. Don't make no sense. And it's annoying because usually on a wall you're doing it like this when realistically it needs to be pressing downward. It's doing the job. It's just because of the tip, if it's not solid, because it's got a spring in there, that's why I had to turn it back, because if I shredded the other end, then there'd be no, can you see that little spring? There's a little spring in there. But now the tip's all messed up. It's like, I ain't getting no spring. So that's why you keep seeing me pinching it to try put all the, now it's like a brush, put all the bristles together so I can create a little spring. But like I said, so on the grout, that's fibrous. Like, okay. Yeah, it's just, it's no longer a tip. It's like a brush. And rubbing that on the grout, it actually caused it to be more, become more really fibrous and where, yeah. Kind of disappointed. So either way, you can come and have a, let me see if I can do a little bit here. See, it's not having it. When it works nice, but you've got to put the pressure on, which is what's causing the brush, which has caused the tip to turn into a brush, which is making a bit of a mess. it looks better. Definitely works. I just wouldn't advise it on a big job. Yeah, I wouldn't advise it on a big job. Like if they sell this solution in a paint pot, I think it'd be better just to get a brush, like a paint brush, not a decorating brush, like a proper, you know, fine art one with a tip, so you could really like how the Japanese painters kind of style brush. I'm feeling like giving up. I was hopeful, but because of the way this tip is and where it's messed up, you can't get the spring action because you can only get the paint out when there's a spring action. I think it's finished. It works. It does work. It's a good thing I read the print to say put gloves on. My hands would be a mess right now. It works. Just a little bit disappointing with the tip. Look. All messed up, and you keep seeing me trying to group all their hair back together so I can get some spring, otherwise the pen's useless without that spring action. Because that's how you get a paint out. You know what, people? It's a bit disappointing. Like, it's cool. It does the job. But it's the tip. Look at the state of it. It's technically non-existent. It's all... Now, this is the other side. That's what it's supposed to look like. And to be honest, I think the paint's run out. Or whatever it is, the solution. But that, like... Just... I think to finish it all, I'm going to need... Maybe 3-4 more. Well, actually, if I'm including all around there, easily 4 more pens. And they're 5er each. Well, that's how much it was when I bought it. And that was in a cheap shop where it would have worked out cheaper than, like, you know, like a B&M. I bought it out somewhere like that, which cost me like $4.99. So in a B&Q, that might be £7. Like, all that fraffing around. And that's only one coat. And they say if it's not great, after an hour when it dries, to do a second coat. There's more solution in a toothpaste tube than there is in that. And I couldn't even tell you if there is, because that nib is messed up so much. I can barely get any spring action to release if there was any paint in there. No. Okay, there is paint in there. I'm calling it paint because I don't know what it's called. Yeah, there is some left in there, but yeah, it's not having it, to be honest. I just can't get enough of the spring action for it to flow now, which is really annoying. Oh, I was excited at the beginning, thinking, yeah, no worries. Now I'm like, psh. That's how I feel. Like, pop up. Psh. Like, doesn't make any sense. Okay, let me show you. Right. You can see there, it actually does work. Look, it looks fresh, it looks nice. I didn't do this bit. You can see the cross section, the vertical and the horizontal lines are different. See that edging is still kind of black, and the lines looks nice. Let's see. It does the job, because look, you can see where I haven't done it, where it starts to go black again. So it does work. I've done all up at the top. Now you can see where I don't have enough paint, but that has covered.